welcome back to the vlog, and without further ado, we're gonna give you the top stories of the day.
Seductress.
Ready? Nah, you see, I was trying to be all theatrical.
Is it like
she's seductive. Looking for a job.
Is it porn you're trying to act in?
Yeah. Perhaps I want to be somebody's assistant for 15 years.
I'm a serious-minded person. When I hear first story, I want to hear the first story. I don't want all these chit chats. It's disturbing my
So all the singing you sing to distract our stories.
You must not sing.
Like OMG.
Proceed.
By the power of likes and posts, two become one.
Ooh. Ooh. Uh-oh.
That's not the title that we gave.
Go ahead. Okay.
On-air personality Tosyn Bucknor has been seen parading her love all over a brand new Instagram account dedicated to just her and the bae.
Ooh la la.
Okay. The Instagram page, which is called @YoruFrench, which we figure is a mix of Yoruba and French, is filled with solo photos of Tosyn and her lover man, Aurelien Boyer. I hope I got that
Aurelien.
Right.
Aurelien.
I think he's French
Aurelien.
Well, there are photos of them together and also some of the activities that they get up to together.
Mm. Wow. Deep.
Okay, it's very deep. Now, this seems to be a new one as we are used to lovers merging bank accounts, residents, but merging social media accounts too? Do you find this creepy or cute?
I don't know. Maybe because she's an on-air personality, I don't think she should be doing that. What if they break up? Although I know maybe French guys are more dedicated than Nigerian
men. Of course, you think they're more dedicated than Nigerian
men. Okay, I'll just say. But then, I don't know. I think it's creepy. I don't think it's cute.
I'm team cute. I think it's definitely cute. If you can merge your bank account, you can merge your residence. What is inside social media?
She's an on-air personality. What if they break up?
So you only live once. Yes, you break up. Do you go into a relationship? You live once. Enjoy the thing. If you want to go all out, go all out. And then when it breaks up, you tell your press people to send a press statement. Finish.
I'd only think it's cute if, say, you were getting ready for a wedding. If there's no wedding, it's kind of odd. And it kind of looks like y'all could just merge your lives on each social media, and if you must put it out there, you know I'm not a fan of putting too much out there.
Yeah.
I mean, you've seen people in deep marriages, and they you kind of keep it private for your own sake.
But see what happens to
like
Flo.
Like, she's an on-air personality.
I think it's cute.
Flo.
Hello, as I was saying.
Okay.
What's with you and this story?
Can you leave these people alone? I think it's cute. Maybe because I know Tosyn Bucknor. I've known her personally over a while. And she's that kind of person. She's like a cutesy kind of person. She likes all this weird stuff. And, you know, she's been in a series of relationships. And I just think it's really cute. And I think they're having a lot of fun
together.
Well,
she's been in a series
of
relationships. Imagine the relationship.
This one is another series.
Imagine if they merged the accounts.
But this one is different, obviously, because she feels confident enough to merge.
You know what would have been
French.
You know what would have been really cool? What would have been really cool was if, say, the Yoruba French thing was to share cultures. You put the Yoruba thing out there. No, they're not. Culture of love. What kind of culture?
But their captions are actually funny. Their captions are about how different they are, about her being Yoruba and him being French. And I think it's actually cool. Like, I actually went through an Instagram page.
I did,
and
too.
I saw some cute, cool stuff, you know, that merged their different cultures and then just some them stuff.
So what aim are they trying to achieve?
Okay, the only thing is before. Before you get to the aim, she went to France. So she met his mother. Wedding bells are, you know, coming.
But
you know,
wow.
Yeah. With everything you guys are saying, all I can think of is how they... K-I-S-S-I-N-G.
Yoruba French.
Oh, baby, Sarambala. Okay.
Yoruba and French kiss. Yoruba kiss and French kiss.
Oh, nice.
I should go out.
My friend, you need to worry about that. So what? Yoruba kiss me.
Ayo.
Can you imagine?
I Yoruba kiss you. You guys don't show me.
I'm standing for all Yoruba people. That is so wrong.
Yorubas are soft.
Very
pleasant.
Amazing. Says, once you go Yoruba, you never go back.
Sure. Do you find merging social media accounts creepy or cute? Let us know what you think. At Cool TV, the blog is the handle on Twitter, and the Facebook page is Cool TV, the blog. And when you drop your comments, use our hashtag.
Love to blog.
That's a personal order.
Love to blog.
Oh, love it. To blog.
Oh, love it. To blog.
This is not like I'm joining in, Abby.
She can relate. Yeah.
Okay, let's jump right into our second story. Access Kim Kanye West. Now it's the
21st
century. You
wanna
sing?
No.
Because you're just like, I didn't give you a chance.
No, so. I'm like,
It's 21st century and girls are putting the first foot forward and they are not afraid to show it. Now, reality star Kim Kardashian West has revealed that even though her husband, rapper Kanye West, is completely besotted with her and uses every opportunity to show it, she was the one who actually made the first move.
Wow. When she was already Bush. Proceed.
Well, her mom made the first move to O.J. Simpson. What a shock.
Kim was actually... Kim recounted the story of how they first met, but the timing was wrong.
Yep.
In an interview with Access Hollywood, she explained, she said, when I first met Kanye, we worked together on a project and there was definitely a spark, but we were in other relationships and we kept our distance. We stayed in touch here and there, but our timing would not always really coincide. She went on to say further, it was 6 months after I was newly single in 2012. I was like, why not? I called Kanye because I'm sure it was really hurtful that I got married. And even though it's not like we communicated all the time, I knew what he was thinking. And then he's always been a good friend to me. Like, we've always been there for each other. He invited me to a fashion show of his in Paris. I went and then the magic happened.
Call it magic.
Now, we hope that story ends with a they lived happily ever after. But the verdict is still out on that because there's still time. Yeah. Now, the question is this. Would a man feel emasculated if his bae revealed that she was the one who made the first move?
Okay. Let's talk about the timing that she's talking about. So at the time, there were rumors. Amber Rose, you know, Amber Rose has always been speaking. Y'all weren't listening way back then when Amber was trying to tell you something.
But why would you listen to Amber when she speaks? It's like breeze.
But in that breeze, you'll catch some truth in the breeze somewhere. But Amber kind of revealed that, I don't know how true this is, but she revealed that when Kim was supposed to be with Reggie and she was supposed to be with Kanye, Kim and Kanye were having something. So Amber and Reggie decided to like have that revenge thing and they actually hooked up. That's what Amber revealed.
That's
Reggie
so
didn't
childish.
Come to say anything else.
I'm telling you.
But I mean, that was actually after Kanye and I think she was saying it right before they actually got together. So I think they've always had something. I get it, the timing wasn't right. I think they've always had something. Now, to the question.
Proceed.
But I think they were just cool.
No, they weren't.
Like, really?
No way,
Kardashian.
Yeah,
it's not a kind of about having that. I've really? Not been in a situation whereby you really like a guy, he's in a relationship,
really?
And you're in a relationship, but you're still very close friends.
Well, I really like a guy, really? I'm in a relationship. Do you want to forget that relationship as if I'm forgetting my past?
You were never
past.
In a relationship to begin
loyal.
With. How do you like somebody if you're with somebody else?
That is someone who and they're married today. And she was telling me her story this week and was very romantic.
Do you know what they call them? Emotional cheaters. And that's actually worse than physical cheating,
actually,
from what I've
the
heard.
Truth.
Well,
boom.
They're not married.
You know, like, what are you gonna do? It's with somebody, you fall for somebody else.
So you've never been in that situation?
No, never.
No, that you're with someone and you fall in love. That's why I said the way I'll leave the person I'm with, because it shows I'm not in love with this
that
person.
That is why Han and Reggie Bush broke up. That's exactly why. They left each other at the end of the day. At the end of the day, they are living happily ever after. Have they given birth? Yes. And who's the baby?
And he's not happily ever after yet.
He's not yet happily ever
after. Let's give it some more years and see how it goes.
Yeah.
But I'm sure Kanye feels good, though. I think this will be a good thing for his ego. I don't think he's going to feel like,
No, but generally, though, like for Nigerian men, do you think... Because I was... Okay. So
I like we just digress from the question.
No, but I answered the question.
I'm going back
to the question now. Kanye likes that. I don't think he'd feel funny, like...
I'm going back to the question now, that for Nigerian men, they might not like it, actually. The fact that... Yeah, they say that. Okay, so the guy, my ex-boyfriend... I didn't make the first move, but the first hello I did, do you understand? I saw him, I liked him, it was nice looking. And I said hello to him. And he made
wearing a short skirt.
No. But he made Swansea. But consequently, he was one who did all the work. You know, there's some men that need a push in the right direction. But, you know, when I was talking about the fact that, we met this way, and I was like, no, that's only for us. That we met another certain way, and I'm thinking of my own business.
No, it's just him. Maybe he's just a humble person, but most guys would love to hear
that you
made the first move.
Yeah, but there's a few guys.
Like, there's a friend of mine who thinks it's just, he thinks he... like he says, if a girl should come after him, he's just gonna be turned off.
It's a big turn off. I can't do it.
No, but,
but that's some guys who actually respect and like it, that you actually had the courage to step up to me, meaning that you saw me, you liked me, you wanted me, and you came.
They like it initially, but very rarely would they. The chase is over. You've given up the chase.
No, but that's what I always say. I don't think it's one size fits all. I never say don't approach a guy because all guys are hunters. Mm-hmm. Because some guys actually appreciate it. Honestly,
I don't want a man like that. I don't want a man that can take charge.
You could go after the guy, but not like
not aggressive. Like
I you're making yourself available.
Yeah.
Give him a push.
Yeah. He was very grateful. When we hooked up, was very, very, and he kept saying thank you for making the first, contact. And I was like, yeah, I can open the door and then you enter.
So did y'all make eye contact like across the room and stuff?
Of course we did,
Well, most Nigerian guys, I don't do this with them, but if I see a good-looking, maybe foreign guy that I like, maybe I'll just greet him.
This is really not like you've ever been with a Nigerian. Like, why do you talk like this?
All our men. But see, why I forget them? Wow.
So there's just one foreigner that just changed your mind for you.
Two.
There are two? There are two?
Yeah. There was a French one then.
There was a French one?
Yeah, but the other one was
there. Oui, oui. No, you went to French school. And we thought it was for development.
True. No, I met him when I was in French school.
Revelations.
Mm. Was it the teacher? Mm.
No.
What was he doing in a French school, being French?
Yeah, exactly.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
No, we used to hang out in, when you're in French school, you hang out in French culture, although it's changed. But then you hang out where, certain places.
Is that where you went to school?
No.
To meet other French people.
So you wanted to learn French?
Yes.
Why? Because she wanted to meet a French
All the languages in our culture.
You wanted to travel to Paris.
My favorite language is actually Spanish. Uh-huh. But French was closer to my house then.
Because of Antonio Banderas.
No!
I think Spanish is a really sexy language.
It's too sexy. And
Please, French is the best.
Okay, let us know what you think. Would a man feel emasculated if his bae revealed that she was one who made the first move? And, guys out there, let us know if you would like a girl to make the first move on you. Hit us up on Twitter at cooltv, the blog is the handle. We're also on Facebook, cooltv, the blog is the page. And when you drop your comments, use the hashtag.
Because
I don't know who's going
to
jump on.
But do you see why the singing was better when I was not around?
We're going to go on a brief break, but before we go on that break, we have a little clip of Kim gushing about her man.
Ooh, la la.
I was always attracted to him. I was always...
Physically or more the...
Both.
The mad genius inside.
Both. But when I first met him, we worked on a project together, and there was definitely a spark, but we were in other relationships, and we kept our distance, and that was really that. And we stayed in touch here and there, and then when he wasn't in relationships, it just, our timing would always not really coincide. And then when I think it was 6 months after I was newly single in 2012, I was like, why not? Why? What am I waiting for?
Did he come after you? Did he pursue you? Or did you call him and say,
I called him.
It's now, bro. Make a move.
Yeah, well, I called him because I'm sure it was really, hurtful that I got married. And even though, him and I, it's not like we communicated all the time. But so I knew what he was thinking. So I thought he was going to call me as soon as he knew that I was single again.
Yeah.
And he didn't. And so I called him and I said, hello. I thought you were at least gonna call me and, say I told you so, something. Then he invited me to a fashion show of his in Paris. And I went. And then...
But you knew you were going...
Then the magic happened. Yeah. But then we both were I was like, okay, is this gonna be it? And then in my head, I was like, screw it. This is probably what I've been waiting for. It's been in front of my face.
Did you hold him at bay for a little while, or did he just come crashing in?
No, I mean, he wasn't. He was. I think he was also cautious. I've expressed myself for you, and it didn't work out, and you got married, and So I think he needed to make sure that I was sure. So he wasn't. I think it was more me pursuing him. I know I am ready. I promise I'm ready now.